thank you very much, Calvin, and I think we should thank him again for having had his students organized to take this case to the attorney. As a matter of work he did, our case would be a great deal weaker, so we thank you very much. Calvin, Arnie had a quick comment that he wanted to make, and so I'm turning the mic over to him before he does the next speaker.
I just wanted to follow up on something that Calvin said, just to show you how hypocritical our government can be. I don't want to criticize people easily, but you should understand this. Calvin said that when the Western Forest Promised Lands came out of TFL 25, there was no consultation with the community, there was no conversation. And that's correct, and that was the genesis of the Auditor General's report. What you should know if you do not know already was that about a year after the Western Forest Promised Lands came out of TFL 25, Pope Talbot and the Kootenays had similar financial problems. And they went to the province and said, can we take some of our private forest lands out of the TFL there and be able to use them to sell off and pay down the debt? And the province said yes, but you're going to have to consult with the community in the Kootenays, and you're going to have to pay compensation. And the company agreed to that, and when we looked at what the community received in terms of money towards parklands, towards establishing a community forest, many of the local businesses had been owed money by Pope Talbot, and Pope Talbot had to pay them off, had to settle their bills as part of the deal. When we looked at what was negotiated and we transferred it into what could come back to our local community if we had been compensated, we calculated in order of $38 million that would have come out of the money that Western Forest Products received or would receive in return for having had their lands removed from the TFL. We went back to the province as a ratepayers association and said, like, what's up, guys? How come a year ago we were not consulted and we were not compensated, and you said that's the way the world was, and a year or so later, another part of the province has a similar problem, and you negotiate with the community and with the company, and people are consulted and are compensated. And we were told, get this, you know, if that's then, this is now, move on. And so, again, you have to understand that this is not a policy that the province has stuck to consistently. They've done what suited them at a particular point in time, and then they've changed their mind again. And that's the hypocrisy that I think some of us have to understand and not be prepared to live with.
Just one point on that, Arnie. We went through Freedom of Information documents on that deal in the Kootenays, and the thing that drove that decision was the uproar that you folks caused a couple of years ago on this piece of property. And it was clear from the government documents that they knew that they could not get away with it again without compensation.
Thank you,
Calvin.
I feel that this game here. I'd just like to add to what Calvin said. I have said myself, since Royal LePage Realty is all the eight owned by the very same people who own Western Forest, it's the same corporate structure, so maybe you'll be seeing a few for sale signs up there from the in-house company that they own to sell land. However, I'd like to thank Vicki Husband for arranging the meeting tonight. She's here as the spokesperson for the Jordan River Steering Committee, but I think we all know her for tremendous work on environmental issues. And I'd like to invite her to come up and fill in some of the details with respect to the UBC proposal and, in fact, knowing Vicki, anything else she has on her mind.